Good afternoon. I'm Don Brennan in for Scott Dennis today. Thank you for joining us. Right off the bat, topping our news at noon, it's closing night of the Democratic National Convention, and Chelsea Clinton will introduce her mother, Hillary, the Democratic National nominee. And ABC's Lauren Lister is going to join us live in Philadelphia on more of what we can expect from tonight and Hillary.
In just a few hours, Hillary Clinton will address this arena. ABC News learning as of this morning she was still working on her speech. It comes just after President Obama made that handoff yesterday night. President Obama handing off the mantle of hope.
The audacity of hope. America, you've vindicated that hope these past 8 years. And now I'm ready to pass the baton.
Obama embracing Hillary Clinton as the woman for his job.
There has never been a man or a woman, not me, not Bill, nobody, more qualified than Hillary Clinton to serve as President of the United States of America.
The White House in full force backing Clinton and tearing down her Republican rival.
He has no clue about what makes America great. Actually, he has no clue, period.
The VP hopeful also taking aim.
Does anybody in this massive auditorium believe that Donald Trump's been paying his fair share of taxes?
And tonight, it's Hillary Clinton's big moment. She'll take this stage, accepting the nomination and addressing the American people.
This coming after Trump's stunning invitation to Russia to hack Clinton's emails.
Russia, if you're listening, I hope you're able to find the 30,000 emails that are missing.
Trump now defending himself on Fox.
I'm being sarcastic.
And the Trump campaign responding to the DNC's night, saying it was filled with empty rhetoric and that a Clinton presidency would amount to a third term for President Obama. Live in Philadelphia, I'm Lauren Lister, ABC News. Now back to you.
Thank you, Lauren. Now, ABC7's Alan Cohn is also joining us from Philadelphia. He spoke to former Florida Governor Bob Graham about his expectations for tonight.
Day four of the Democratic National Convention, Hillary Clinton's big night, and joining us is former Florida Senator and former Florida Governor Bob Graham. Senator, thank you so much for joining us. It's Hillary Clinton's big night, but the big storyline continues to be that top Democrats are trying to connect the dots between the Trump campaign, whether it's Paul Manafort or Trump himself, to the Russian government and the WikiLeaks leak of emails. What's your impression?
I'm unaware of any connection between Mr. Trump or Mr. Manafort or anyone else involved in this campaign and the Russian government. And frankly, if I did know something, probably would be classified and I couldn't talk about it. I think it is a serious issue when a candidate for president of the United States essentially is asking citizens of a country with which we have very tenuous relations, Russia, to hack in to the private mail of a U.S. citizen, which would be a criminal act in the United States, and an act of espionage if conducted by a foreign citizen. And I think this campaign needs to get beyond that sort of level of discussion, start talking about the things that people are really interested in.
What do you hope to hear from Hillary Clinton tonight?
I hope that she'll talk about things in enough detail that people can understand how are we going to manage an economy which is becoming increasingly globalized and technology-driven and still provide opportunities for all Americans to live the good life. I think second, what is the role of the federal government in education and how far can it go without impinging on our tradition of local control? And then in the area of health care, very important in a state like Florida, what is her feelings about the future of Obamacare? Mr. Trump has said he will repeal it on the first day in office, which would be a very unusual thing for the president to do. as president to repeal a piece of legislation, but that's what he said. What does she think should be the areas of improvement to Obamacare?
Senator, thank you very much. That will wrap it up for noon, but of course, please follow events on Facebook, on the air all day long. It's going to be a very exciting day here in Philadelphia. Reporting in Philadelphia, I'm Alan Cohen at the Democratic National Convention. Back to you.
Thank you, Alan. Joining us right now, as you said, a lot of hot air being blown over the last couple of weeks at both conventions, but some of it obviously very meaningful, but there is a lot of hot air right here in Florida.
My goodness, we can't get away from it either. And it doesn't matter what time you wake up in the day, it's hot. It just doesn't seem to make any difference. It's either hot and humid or just hotter and humid. That seems to be the case. And we are looking at temperatures right now that have already approached 90 degrees for many locations. The rain continues to move away from shore, and we are not looking at anything developing right here across our immediate area. So we're not seeing any showers that are going to spoil your afternoon, early afternoon to the beach. However, we are looking at a temperature reading right now of 92 degrees, and you can see temperatures all around the region are mostly in the 90s right now. So it's another hot day today, and we're expecting to top out at 94.
Wow. Well, thank you, Wendy. New at noon, Sarasota police have found stolen bikes, and now they need your help in locating their owner. Police found six high-end bicycles last Friday around 1 a.m. in the area of School and Arlington Road in Sarasota. Due to the recent thefts, police also want to remind bikers of a few safety tips.
Folks can lock their bicycles up and make sure not to just leave them out. You know, if you're just running into your house or, you know, you're staying at home overnight, make sure it's locked to the carport, bring it inside if you can, and make sure you get a lock to lock your bicycle that can't be destroyed.
I will say I had a bike stolen from South Sarasota a few years ago, and sheriff's office had it right back in my hands within 2 hours. Police say you can also register your bike with the police department just in case it ever is stolen. Also new at noon, red light cameras can be annoying, but getting rid of them can be deadly. According to a study by the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety, traffic deaths from red light running crashes have gone up nearly a third after cities turn off the cameras. Trends in annual crash rates were compared with cities who ended the cameras versus cities who didn't. They found that red light running crashes went up 30%. At least 158 communities have ended their red light camera programs in the past 5 years. And plans are on track to close a major road in the middle of Sarasota for at least a year and probably more. The closure could have some after effects as well. Starting on Monday, the city will close Osprey Avenue between Mound and Bella Vista. Engineers will be working around the Osprey Avenue Bridge to start the long-awaited sewage station project in nearby Lukewood Park. The city has sent out 2,000 postcards warning residents and business owners about this closure. But some residents worry the closure will severely impact businesses on the Southside Village.
Wow, it's really going to impact this area in a negative way for these businesses along here. There's a couple new businesses right over here that are just getting started, and it's really, really going to make it difficult for them.
The city says they'll do what they can to make this project as painless as possible. They're suggesting you take US 41 to Hillview and bypass Osprey for the next 18 months, excuse me. The road will close at 10 a.m. after the morning rush hour on Monday morning, August 1st. The sewage station project is scheduled to be complete in 4 years. And a decline in manufacturing is pushing one major plant to cut back on jobs. The Air Products facility in Port Manatee has laid off 30 of its employees. That's according to the company's spokesman. He's blaming the cuts on a global decline in equipment orders. Air Products creates liquefied natural gas heat exchangers, and they take about 2 years to make. The $50 million plant opened near Port Manatee in 2014. During the last 6 months, the company also let go of 40 of its employees from their plant in Pennsylvania. Overall, 70 positions have now been eliminated, but the company says they're confident the business will bounce back. And from jobs lost to possible jobs gained, Manatee County hosted its annual Business Community Outreach Expo this morning. It's taking place right now at the Bradenton Convention Center, and experts are there offering tips on how to successfully conduct business, specifically in Manatee County. And Manatee County officials are also there discussing upcoming and current projects local businesses can take part in. Each year, the county hopes to, you know, have the expo better than the previous year.
Our programming has become incredibly more vibrant from year to year. Every single year we survey the participants and we ask them what their expectations were, and we look at what we've done and what we feel we need to do.
This is the fourth year of the expo. Some bright news in the community of Rebonia. A neighborhood action plan has determined that the community is a blighted area and qualifies for a community development grant. A draft of the plan includes improvement projects such as adding sidewalks and streetlights throughout the area. Some work could begin as early as October. Now, 88% of Rebonia homes are defined as being low to moderate income households. The improvement plan will be up for approval by the County Commission on August 23rd. It will then need to be approved by the Department of Housing and Urban Development. Time now to head over to the kitchen and check in with our guest chef, Jose Rojas from Louis Modern in Sarasota. Chef Jose, what's good on the menu today?
Hello, guys. Today I'm going to show you how to make a rice cracker cross bluefin tuna. So it's going to be good.
Shop GoWildHonda.com. Lease a new Civic for $174 and no down payment, just $174. Get great clearance deals now at GoWildHonda.com or visit Wild Honda Sarasota. It's gotta be wild.
Hurricane season is here. Are you prepared? ABC7 has the information you need. Access our special Surviving a Hurricane now. Learn how to prepare a readiness plan and survival kit. Know your evacuation route. Be prepared, Suncoast, when severe weather threatens. Access our special on our ABC7 app and all our live streaming platforms.
Apple TV, Amazon Fire TV, and Roku.
Donald Trump and the Republicans went first.
Oh, we're going to win. We're going to win so big.
Now it's Hillary Clinton and the Democrats' turn.
We are on the brink of a historic moment.
So what will happen next in this extraordinary election year?
We can do this.
And ABC7 is your Suncoast connection to it all, bringing you live reports and updates all week from the Democratic National Convention. ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names.
Really?
They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
Call right now to get your free Senior Care Compass ebook. Find out about the five best kept secrets on financing senior care and assisted living.
Call now, 800-290-0352, 800-290-0352.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free, andservices.com, andservices.com.
Shop GoWildHonda.com. Lease a new Accord for $189 and no down payment, just $189 or 0.9% APR. Get great clearance deals now at GoWildHonda.com or visit Wild Honda Sarasota. It's gotta be wild.
Well, it's over. As of today, we are going to start to see more moisture going to be filtering into the state of Florida. We've had this dry air sitting on top of us for the past couple of days. That's helped to suppress any rain chances, at least bringing it down to a 20 to 30% chance. But beginning tomorrow, our rain chances will go up, and that will help to cool our temperatures off as well. What we have right here is this moisture that's developing in the Atlantic will eventually start to make its way over here across the state of Florida. And so this dry air that we've had being brought in over the last couple of days is going to change. And rainfall amounts have not been all that much. They haven't been very impressive. you know that it was showering last night. We had thunderstorms around. We had some lighter rains that took place. We also had one area that really experienced some heavier showers, and that was east of I-75 over the central part of Sarasota County. And that's been the heaviest amounts of rainfall we've seen over the past 2 days. This has been about all we're getting, and that keeps us in a deficit situation. And as a result of the drier conditions, we've been seeing our temperatures soar because there's nothing to help cool things off. So 94 degrees is the expected projected high for the day, and we could see that developing beginning at around 1 o'clock this afternoon. We're already approaching it at this hour. And as you can see, most of the rain that we have around the state beginning to move in across the southeastern part of Florida, and that's going to start to track on up towards the northwest. We also have showers out here in the Gulf of Mexico. They continue to move away, and right here on shore right now, nothing much is happening. So we're not looking for any rain showers to start until late in the afternoon and throughout the early evening hours. Right now it's 92 degrees. The humidity has dropped down just a little bit. So has the dew point levels. And the winds are coming in out of the east southeast at around 10 miles per hour. Around the state right now, just about everyone reporting the hot temperatures. You can see all along the eastern coastline, readings are in the low to mid 90s. And along the west coast of Florida in Tampa, it's 89 degrees right now. We're seeing a couple of 80s right here across the northwestern sections of Manatee County, but everyone else is falling into place with those very hot temperatures at this hour in the low 90s right now. As a result of the dissipating dry air, we're also starting to see things getting a little bit more concentrated coming in off the coast of Africa. And there's the possibility we may see some development taking place there. We'll know in the next couple of days, because right now there's a 40% chance of that happening. And this is developing just to the south and east of the Cape Verde Islands. It's moving towards the west right now. And again, only a 40% chance of development of that system. And that's something we're definitely going to be keeping our eyes on for you and keep you posted as to what's going on there. For boaters, winds will be coming in out of the southeast and then shifting around later today to the south at 10 knots, seas 1 to 2 feet with a light chop. We'll have a couple of showers and some isolated thunderstorms around. We're also going to see a temperature reading of 90 degrees, and we've got a Gulf water temperature of 89 degrees. So that's what's happening. And as we take a look at the rest of the day today, oh my goodness, it gets up to 94 for the daytime high. Those thunderstorms will be in play, and we've only got a 30% chance of rain, so they'll be isolated, and then we up those chances starting tomorrow with a 40 to 50% chance. Don?
Thank you, Wendy. Topping our health news today, the FDA has opened a federal investigation into a popular shampoo sold by infomercial. Last week, the FDA received 127 complaints against Hollywood hairstylist Chaz Dean's Wen Cleansing Conditioner. According to the lawsuit, at least six women allege they lost clumps of their hair after using the product. It's the largest number of reports ever associated with any cosmetic hair cleansing product, including cleansing conditioners. Complaints include hair breakage, hair loss, itchiness, and rash. The FDA is not sure what's causing this reaction. The government is calling on the company to provide any data that might help them understand the problem. And a cutting-edge medical glue designed to help people has now gone to the dogs. Doctors in Boston used it to help fix a painful dental problem for a pooch. ABC's Ben Simino has the story.
He's a punk. Everybody knows Poppy as a punk.
They're both tough on the outside, little Poppy and his owner, John Shanahan. They're big Red Sox fans, too, if you couldn't tell by the name.
David Ortiz, my favorite Red Sox player.
Poppy couldn't always run around like this. A dental disease caused a painful opening in his mouth that three surgeries could not fix, and it slowed him down.
It gets full of hair and infection, very uncomfortable for Poppy.
Just when Shanahan had all but given up, Dr. William Rosenblatt at MSPCA Angel got creative, calling for help from a hospital that treats people, not animals.
He had heard of this material that might be good for Poppy, and I didn't even hesitate. I said, let's do it, because I was out of options.
We've been developing tissue adhesives in my laboratory for the past 10 years or so, multiple different platforms, glues that can work inside the body, including inside a beating heart.
The glue, which was developed at Brigham and Women's, worked. It closed the hole, and Poppy's mouth is healing. Now, little Poppy can go back to watching big Poppy at Fenway and at home, always by Shanahan's side.
I'm grateful to all of them. I'm grateful to this hospital. it's the only hospital that I'll bring him to. To bring him here and to get the treatment that he's gotten has it's been worth it. You know, it's been worth it.
Now, they always say Poppy's the glue that holds the team together, and now the glue's holding Poppy together. Still to come on your Suncoast News, learning to read, reading to learn, how the Manatee County School District is investing in the future of our children. But first, what animal took a bite out of a former Buccaneer player? We'll tell you all about that coming up next.
My dad is my hero, and I wanted to give him a chance to live life and be happy. Granny Nannies has been a huge help. It has contributed to the health and happiness of my dad, for sure.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
From a baby's first steps to walking your daughter down the aisle, so many of life's precious moments are spent on our feet, and every step you take contributes to a healthier heart. By walking briskly for just 30 minutes a day, you can lower your risk for heart disease and stroke. So join us and take the first step to a healthier, longer life. The American Heart Association. Life. Life is why.
Tomorrow at 5 on ABC7's Good Morning Suncoast.
Hello, I'm Don Brennan. Through sickness and health, it turns out your marital status could help you live longer. Tomorrow on Good Morning Suncoast, we'll show you how a spouse can help lower your odds of dying from a heart attack. Wendy?
And we are finally getting back to normal as far as our weather is concerned, with a 50% chance of rain back in the forecast.
Tomorrow at 5 on ABC7's Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you. Watch ABC7 reporting live from Philadelphia today.
Attention, this is an important message for anyone who had an IVC filter placed to prevent blood clots from traveling to their heart or lungs. Did your IVC filter move, break, or cause organ damage? The FDA warns that IVC filters may cause serious complications, such as heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, even death. If you or a loved one suffered serious complications, call IVC Filter Helpline now. You may be entitled to compensation. IVC filters are designed to prevent blood clots. If your IVC filter moved or broke, and you suffered heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, or if a loved one died as a result, call IVC Filter Helpline today. Our network of experienced attorneys is ready to fight for you. You'll pay nothing unless there's a recovery in your favor. Call today for a free confidential consultation. Don't fight this alone. Call IVC Filter Helpline now.
Please call 800-897-6764. That is 800-897-6764.
Granny Nannies. We've been making house calls for over 25 years. When you need home health care services, there really is no place like home.
Grandma!
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Welcome back. Despite a doping scandal that has depleted Russia's Olympic team significantly, many athletes are still hoping to compete in this year's Summer Games in Rio. The team left on a charter flight early this morning from Moscow. The team was 387 athletes strong, but is now just a little more than 100 after an investigation found many of them were doping. Last week, the International Olympic Committee decided to ignore a call for a blanket ban over allegations of state-backed doping in Russia. Russian Olympic officials say the country is willing to fix the problem.
I think now the Russian team is the cleanest team in the world. This team, which is going today to Rio.
The International Olympic Committee says they will not reconsider their decision. The entire Russian track and field team was banned from the Olympics. Now back in the States, golf's final major of the season is underway. The PGA Championship kicked off today in New Jersey at Baltusrol. Now, Tiger Woods isn't playing, but there are still several storylines to follow. One is Henrik Stenson, the winner of the British Open earlier this month, is hoping to claim his second major in 3 weeks. He tees off at 145, along with Jason Day, the number one currently. He'll attempt to defend his title after winning last year's PGA Championship at Wisconsin's Whistling Straits. Leading the pack right now, Viva l'Argentina, Emiliano Grillo is leading at 4-under on 18. He is followed by Jimmy Walker, who is through 15, and Jason Day is at 3-under. Now, Pro Football Hall of Famer and former Buccaneer Warren Sapp has been accused of being as mean as a shark at times. Well, he met his match while diving for lobsters in the Keys yesterday. He was actually reaching for a lobster, but a shark had the same idea, and Sapp was bitten by a 4-foot nurse shark right there on his forearm. A picture of the gash posted on a fishing charter boat's Instagram account. The captain tells media outlets that Sapp was going for that same lobster as a shark, and that's not a good idea. He is okay. Yesterday, he posted a picture of the lobster catch on his Twitter account with the caption, "Shark got a little chuck of me. We got dinner. Hashtag winning." And from one lobster to another, a decades-old crustacean that gained fame after being saved from a Florida dinner table didn't make it to retirement. Larry the Lobster has passed away. The 15-pounder succumbed during its journey from a Sunrise, Florida restaurant to the Maine State Aquarium. Last week, a rescue group banded together to relocate Larry to the aquarium after the restaurant owner had a change of heart and spared him from the pot. The aquarium was supposed to decide if he would be released to the wild or put on exhibit. It's not clear what actually killed the lobster. Larry was estimated to be between 60 and 110 years old. Now let's see if Chef Jose has lobster. I know he's got some kind of seafood.
Today.
No lobster from Louis Modern. Jose Rojas is joined by Wendy.
And happily, I want to tell you that this is fresh. This is not 60 years old today, which is wonderful. Isn't that great?
Thank you, guys.
Jose, what are you making for us today?
We are going to make a rice cracker, crushed bluefin tuna.
Okay.
So we are going to start making the sauce, which is going to be 1/2 cup of orange juice, same 1/2 cup of lime juice, 3 egg yolks.
And you're making the sauce to do what? What is the...
That's going to be underneath of the tuna.
Oh, okay.
It could be underneath of the tuna. It can be for deep, too.
So oh, okay.
There's going to be 1 teaspoon of sriracha. It's going to be 1/4 of teaspoon orange oil.
Orange oil? Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
And we are going to... This is bonito flakes. We are going to let them soak in water, but we are going to use only the water. For the
I see, and
sauce.
This is just adding a flavoring then.
Flavor.
Is what you're
and
looking
a little
for.
Bit of color too.
Okay. And this is going to be found at the bottom of the plate. So this is
plate.
What's going to give it a nice, mm-hmm. a nice taste, a nice addition
dish.
To what you're serving.
So we're going
to
start blending. Okay. We're going to add the grapeseed oil.
Okay.
Slowly.
Grapeseed oil, which is a little bit lighter than the olive oil, but you can do it either interchangeably or is it just best to go out and get the grapeseed? That never happens to me.
You can add a little bit of salt to taste.
Okay. Wow, that is nice and loud. What I was just asking is the olive oil, is it interchangeable with the grapeseed oil or is that something you just want to make sure you
It's actually lighter
okay.
than the olive oil, cleaner
yeah.
than the olive oil. So it's used for dressings and salads. So it's not, a lot of people don't send like the flavor of olive oil because it's
yes.
a little bit stronger.
It's a little bit heavier. Mm-hmm.
So
we've got
our
about
sauce is
2 minutes.
Ready. Okay, this is our tuna. We are going to cut in flour. And this is my mix of plum sauce
okay.
and egg beaters. And we are going to coat it with the rice cracker.
And this is what you're putting over this sauce that you've just made.
True.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And you get it
so our
it's
oil
nice
should
in there.
Be,
and this is olive oil.
Should be ready.
Yeah.
And it's going to be a flash fry.
Because this is a sushi, so you don't want to cook it too long.
No.
You want to have it so that it's nice and crispy on the outside,
mm-hmm.
and then it's got that lovely flavor on the inside.
So I know we don't have that much time, so I'm going to bring my other tuna that is ready, and I'm going to slice it.
Oh, and look how perfect that is. Now, I have to say, we've also brought all these other salads that has been brought to our studio today with all these wonderful flavors and all these great tastings, especially for this time of the year.
It's very refreshing.
Because it is very refreshing, that's right. And right now, if you're looking for something a little bit summery, and it's 94 degrees today, so you might want to go and find a lighter kind of a meal just to get through the afternoon. That would be nice to do.
This will be
and that's
our
how
final
it's gonna
plate.
Look. Okay. And I just want to remind everybody that you can go to our dining page and you'll be able to find this recipe so that you can make this at home. And we're going to enjoy it here in the studio. And we want to thank you for coming down.
Thanks for having me.
And showing us how to make this wonderful
dish. Thanks again.
We'll be right back.
at 4 on Suncoast View.
If you can't take the heat, get out of her kitchen. I'm Stephanie Roberts. On Suncoast View, we have a superstar child cook here to tell us about her national TV reality show appearance and give us some cooking tips. Our travel expert tells us where you can spend the holidays this year exploring Christmas markets, plus a Friday Fest preview, and Lowe's Don Cesar joins us in the kitchen.
Today at 4 on Suncoast View.
Record-setting hot weather means your AC is working overtime to keep your home cool, which can lead to high bills. That's why we're bringing in the energy experts from Florida Power and Light Company. Watch ABC 7 News from 5 to 6:30 this Tuesday to get your questions answered during the FPL Ask the Energy Expert phone bank. From smart technology to free online tools, learn how to save energy and money only on ABC 7.
Just because someone grows older, does that mean they have to grow apart from their friends or from the things they love to do? With Right at Home, it doesn't. Right at Home's professional team thoughtfully selects caregivers to help with personal care, housekeeping, meals, and most of all, staying engaged in life.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. Are you ready to go?
Oh, I sure am.
We can provide the right care right at home.
Dog days of summer got you down? Beat the heat with huge summer savings during the summer clearance event going on now at Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota. You'll feel cooler than ever when you drive away in a new Jeep Cherokee for as little as $19,999. Or take home a stylish new Jeep Renegade for just $18,599. How about a new 2016 Jeep Patriot for just $14,999? Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota.
Are you one of the millions of Americans suffering from chronic knee pain, arthritis, or osteoarthritis of the knee? Have you been told knee replacement surgery is your only option? Then call the number on your screen and see if you qualify for a breakthrough treatment that is helping people like you find relief from knee pain without pills or surgery. This innovative treatment utilizes an FDA-approved product that replenishes the lubricant in your joints that may be lost over time or as a result of injury. This all-natural lubricant is introduced into the knee where it creates a cushioning layer that protects the joint, helping it to move smoothly and without pain. This emerging treatment is covered by most insurance, including Medicare, and is considered by many to be the first major breakthrough for relieving knee pain in years. So if you're tired of living with knee pain, call the number on your screen right now to see if you may be a candidate for this emerging knee pain treatment. It might be the knee pain treatment that changes your life and gets you back on your feet for good.
Live from our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is ABC 7 News at noon. Your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Welcome back. I'm Don Brennan in for Scott Dennis. It's the final night of the Democratic National Convention, and after major speeches, two epic speeches by both Barack Obama and Michelle Obama, it will be Hillary Clinton's turn to formally accept the nomination and look forward to November. Last night, Clinton surprised the audience, joining President Obama as he endorsed her. The two on stage together marked a historical moment, the country's first African-American president embracing his first female nominee for president. The president himself stated his case for Clinton, saying there has never been a man or a woman more qualified to be president, and says the Democratic Party is in good hands.
And there is only one candidate in this race who believes in that future, has devoted her life to that future, a leader with real plans to break down barriers and blast through glass ceilings and widen the circle of opportunity to every single American, the next president of the United States, Hillary Clinton.
Vice presidential nominee Tim Kaine, Vice President Joe Biden, and former New York City Mayor Michael Bloomberg also took the stage. Clinton will make her acceptance speech tonight. And the Democrats who addressed the convention last night are more convinced than ever that Donald Trump is a candidate of fear and someone unfit for the office following his latest headline. The Republican nominee called on Russia to find and release emails deleted from Hillary Clinton's private server from her time as Secretary of State. But now he's saying he was only kidding around, being sarcastic. Trump's comments come as speculation widens about Russia's alleged involvement in the email hacking of the Democratic National Convention Committee. Trump addressed the issue on an interview today with Fox News.
And when I'm being sarcastic with something, first of all, they don't even know. Of course I'm being sarcastic, but you have 33,000 emails deleted. And the real problem is what was said on those emails from the Democratic National Committee.
Overnight, Moscow responded, saying Russia would never interfere with another country's election. After Trump's comments, online searches for the definition of treason surged. But a legal expert tells ABC that his comments are not criminal, but protected by free speech. And ABC7's Haley Wilgus has been in Philadelphia all this week with the rest of the team covering the Democratic National Convention, but she took a break from politics to check out some of the city's most famous and popular sites.
Welcome to Philadelphia, the site of the 2016 Democratic National Convention and the place where so much of America's history lies. The Declaration of Independence was signed here, as was the Constitution. It's also the city Rocky made famous. We'll talk about that in a minute, but first, let's head to the Liberty Bell. We're here at the Visitor Center for the Liberty Bell. As you can tell, a popular spot in Philadelphia and a must-do if you're visiting the city.
There is much debate over during which momentous moments the Liberty Bell actually rang. But one time it reportedly did not ring was on July 4th, 1776, although it likely did sound to mark the reading of the Declaration of Independence. And what's a trip to the City of Brotherly Love without stopping by the Philadelphia Museum of Art to run the steps Rocky made famous? Adam Cellini and I took the challenge. Nightlife options are plentiful in Philly, including inside the Wells Fargo complex where the DNC is being held. At Xfinity Live, plenty of dining and entertainment options. And as you can see behind us, CNN even opened their own grill for the convention. In Philadelphia, Haley Wilgus, ABC7, your Suncoast News.
Thank you, Haley. In other news, an update now on the wildfire in California. As of today, officials have contained 10% of that blaze. So far, the fire has destroyed 34 homes in Los Angeles County and charred 37 square miles. Also in California, a mysterious light streaking across the sky is sending social media into a frenzy. The phenomenon is called the Delta Aquarids meteor shower. The meteor showers form when Earth crosses the orbital path of a comet. Bits of dust and debris are the remnants of the comet, and these light up the sky when they enter and burn up in our atmosphere. The shower has been sprinkling across the night sky for a few days. Its peak times are tonight and tomorrow night. The best time to see it is between midnight and just before dawn. So just look to the south for the best view of the Delta Aquarids. Aquarids?
I don't know. You got me on that one. I don't
that
know.
Is. I got you. I stumped you.
Wow, you did.
Stumped the Swami. That?
I'm still thinking about Haley running up those stairs in high heels, no
I was
less.
Saying, she was high in heels, and Adam.
He looked good, though. He looked strong.
He did, but he looked like he was kind of keeping
but
pace.
But he was not wearing heels.
But Haley, yeah, he wasn't wearing heels. And Haley, I'll tell you, she works out hard, so I
yeah,
think she could take him.
She could.
Knock
she
him into tomorrow, right?
I tell you what, she could probably beat out the Russian Olympic team.
Or Drago. She must break him.
You go. Well, we are looking at very hot conditions out there right now, and we already have a couple of showers that are starting to make their way in across the southeastern coastline, and they're moving onto the southern sections of the state. Most of the rain has dissipated. We had showers very early this morning throughout the overnight hours, and they had moved out into the Gulf of Mexico. And so far, we've just seen nothing but sunshine around our area tonight, or today, and today. To right now, right now it's 92 degrees. It's very hot out. We're expecting it to get a little bit hotter. 94 is the expected high.
Thank you, Wendy. And it was a bit of a trip up for Pope Francis today. While walking up to an altar in Poland, the Pope tripped up. He tripped on a step, but he wasn't injured. Thankfully, he got back on his feet pretty quickly. And the Pope is in Poland celebrating the 1,050th anniversary of Christianity in the country. He's also celebrating World Youth Day. Speaking of the youth, back here on the Suncoast with a new school year fast approaching, a local nonprofit is looking for donations to help families in need of school clothes. The Children's Clothing Closet at Turning Points offers free clothing for children in need, and they're looking for the public's help to fill the racks with more clothes. They need donations of gently used or new clothes for all sizes for both girls and boys. The nonprofit says they're really short on clothing for girls between the sizes of 2 toddler and size 16. For boys, they're looking for more preteen and teen clothes. Underwear and socks are also needed. Anyone who would like to help bring a bag of clothes to Turning Points with the name Herrera written on it is asked to do so. United Way Manatee kicked off major campaigns this morning with eggs and bacon, but it's all for the long-term success of our children. The nonprofit hosted a breakfast to launch its Manatee Mind Trust. It's United Way's newest initiative to help children move from learning to read to reading to learn. It's a key factor, organizers say, is important to better predict future graduation rates and earnings. Now, the breakfast took place at Manatee Technical College. Some of Manatee County's largest employers and community partners were present, including Manatee County Superintendent Dr. Diana Green. Everyone was there for a common purpose, to support education, health, and stability for Manatee County families.
The work of United Way is about redefining what it means to be an individual philanthropist. Because we have a collective approach to addressing challenges, everybody can make a difference on a community level.
United Way of Manatee County is putting more than $150,000 towards local programs to assist in this initiative. In consumer news, a new study is showing that the number of extra fees tacked onto credit cards is shrinking. That's according to creditcards.com. The 100 cards reviewed in the study had a total of 593 fees compared to 613 fees last year. Customers can be charged for everything from exceeding their credit limit to transferring a balance, with typical cards carrying about 6 fees. One of the fastest disappearing fees is a charge for receiving a paper copy of a past statement. Coming up, Wendy has another look at our weather forecast, and if you missed the stink the first time around, you'll have another chance to see it or smell it, a preview of the other corpse flower that's hiding in Selby Gardens.
Watch ABC7 reporting live from Philadelphia today.
This is a special health alert for seniors suffering with joint pain. If you have Medicare insurance, you may qualify for high-quality support braces at little or no cost.
I'm thrilled with my knee braces.
Now, there is a simple and proven solution for seniors to get out of pain with state-of-the-art support braces.
I barely feel any pain at all.
Braces for your knees and back, as well as your shoulders and ankles, too.
I'm so happy with the quality of these braces.
Call now, and you could qualify for a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost.
I can play ball again, and it doesn't hurt.
And because of my Medicare coverage, it costs me next to nothing.
So call now.
And because I have this red, white, and blue Medicare card, my braces have cost me just about nothing.
It's true. You may get a knee, back, shoulder, and ankle brace at little or no cost.
They qualified me for 2 knee braces and a back brace.
If you have knee or back pain, give them a call. They can help.
1-800-476-8967. 1-800-476-8967.
They say good things come to those that wait. Well, you've waited long enough. You deserve to feel fabulous in your fashionable new Fiat 500X from Alfa Romeo Fiat in Sarasota. Boldly innovative, seductively stylish. Fiat gives you everything you'd expect from a capable utility vehicle, like a spacious interior and advanced safety systems, designed and built like a sexy little sportster. Don't wait any longer. You deserve to feel fabulous. Get a new Fiat at Alfa Romeo Fiat of Sarasota.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today, sleep on it tonight.
Well, we have lots of sunshine going on right now, and we're also going to see our temperatures topping out into the mid-90s today. Some places east of I-75 of the central part of the state could see their temperatures in the 95, 96 degree range, but we're expecting to see 94, and that's hot enough. Not a whole lot in the way of rain is in the forecast, but we will get that 30% chance of rain today. Again, we have had that drier air sitting on top of us for the last couple of days, and that has allowed those rain chances to be on the low side, but we're going to change all that starting tomorrow with about a 40 to 50% chance of rain back in the forecast again. So a little bit more moisture is coming back in. We've got a couple of showers down to our south. They're going to be moving off towards the northwest. So far, we've not seen anything across central Florida. And then we also have the rain that's located out in the Gulf of Mexico, and that has been continuously moving away from our area. So we're not looking at any showers coming at us from the Gulf over the next couple of hours. It is 92 degrees right now. It is warm out there. We've got plenty of sunshine around. Dew point has come down. The humidity is not too high right now, and the winds are coming in out of the east southeast at 10 miles per hour. Yesterday we had a record high of 97 degrees, and so today, could we get that hot again? It's possible. We are looking at those temperatures already on the east coast at 94 in some places. We're looking at 94 degrees in Parrish already, and as you can see along the Sun Coast, we've got temperatures mostly in the low 90s right now, and it is going to get hotter. And because of the lack of that dry air that is now beginning to subside, we'll start to see the tropics getting a little bit more active. So far, there's nothing going on in the Gulf or the Caribbean, but we are looking at a system just south of the Cape Verde Islands. There's a 40% chance of it developing as it continues to move towards the west, and that could take place over the next 5 days. So we'll keep you posted on that and let you know what's going on there. For this afternoon, a few isolated showers and maybe the possibility of a thunderstorm, just as we saw yesterday, and bringing about the same kind of rainfall that we experienced yesterday. The winds will start in out of the southeast, shift around to the south at 10 knots, seas 1 to 2 feet with a light chop. We are going to be hot at the beaches, though, 90 degrees there, the Gulf water temperature 89 degrees. And this is what it's going to look like over the next couple of days with our temperature staying in the 90s. Overnight lows will be in the upper 70s and a 30% chance of rain today, but a 40% to 50% chance after that. Don?
Yeah, thank you, Wendy. Happening tonight, Sarasota County will decide whether or not the county or residents should be in charge of cutting the grass in areas of the right-of-way along roadways. The county commissioner will consider this change, and that would save them about $500,000 each year. The first public meeting about the changes will be held at the Venice Community Center tonight. It starts at 5 and is expected to go till about 7. Coming up, an NFL quarterback is being pretty quiet about his brother's involvement in a reality TV show. And one Pokemon Go guy managed to catch them all, literally, and now he's looking for a bigger challenge. That's coming up next in entertainment.
Hurricane season is here, so when severe weather threatens, count on the official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7.
We bring you storm warnings faster and with more detail than ever before.
And track storms right down to your neighborhood.
On air, online, and on your mobile device, turn to the official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
On Animal Outtakes, every week, it's a new animal adventure.
From meeting curious lemurs to feeding big cats and hosing down rhinos, there's never a dull moment. And sometimes these amazing animals chime in. Tune in to Animal Outtakes to find out what they have to say.
Watch Animal Outtakes this weekend on ABC 7.
Florida Studio Theater presents The Roommate by Jen Silverman, now playing through August 7th. Brooklyn meets Iowa City when Sharon finds a sensible roommate, but it's far from what she expected. Don't miss what critics are saying is laugh-out-loud funny, with unexpected turns and emotional depth. The Roommate is now playing through August 7th. Purchase tickets now by calling 941-366-9000 or visiting floridastudiotheater.org.
U.S. Med has great news for anyone living with diabetes.
If you have Medicare, private insurance, or prescription drug coverage, U.S. Med will ship a new glucose meter right to your home.
And shipping is free.
My new meter uses only a speck of blood, so it's less painful than my previous meter.
If you have Medicare, private insurance, or prescription drug coverage, you're covered with US Med. We're welcoming new patients, even if your current provider can't supply you anymore.
I don't even have to test on my fingers anymore. I can test on my hand or forearms, and it's more accurate than my old meter.
So call US Med today, and you'll have a choice of two great meters.
One that actually speaks your results, or a meter so small it fits in the bottle of strips.
Act now, and US Med will include a free prescription discount card. We'll also send you a free diabetes cookbook. This is your opportunity.
So call US Med today.
You'll be glad you did.
We've been slow smoking over oak for more than 45 years. And while sticking to tried and true traditions is kind of our thing, it doesn't hurt to throw something new in the smoker every now and then. Come get some slow-smoked chicken wings at Sonny's Barbecue. Order them as an appetizer or as part of a combo with pork, baby back ribs, or both, starting at $10.99. Sonny's Barbecue, local pitmasters since 68.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere for the Sarasota Ford Promise. Our promise means a new car you'll love. If not, return it for one you do. At Sarasota Ford, we promise live market pricing. We monitor national pricing on our entire inventory, so you get the best deal. In fact, we guarantee it. Bring us any competitor's ad, and we'll beat it by at least $1,000. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
Welcome back, everybody. Green Bay Packers quarterback Aaron Rodgers is not saying much about his relationship with his reality show contestant brother. Jordan Rodgers is one of the suitors on The Bachelorette. During a recent episode, Jordan said he was estranged from his older sibling. The two-time NFL MVP says he hasn't seen the show and found it quite inappropriate to talk about family matters, basically saying, it's none of your business. And it's not. Netflix has released a trailer for its reboot of The Gilmore Girls. The new show, called Gilmore Girls: A Year in the Life, features four 90-minute episodes about a single mother and the daughter she's raising. Stars Lauren Graham, Alexis Bledel, and Melissa McCarthy are returning for the reboot. It starts streaming in November, and Lauren Graham has said this will be her last hurrah as an actress. Speaking of actresses, young actress Mackenzie Foy will be taking the center stage in Disney's live-action take on The Nutcracker. According to The Hollywood Reporter, the interstellar star has been cast in the lead role of Clara, the little girl whose toy Nutcracker comes to life. Producers hope to start filming in the fall. And finally, one guy is currently the envy of all Pokemon Go players. Brooklyn native Nick Johnson is the first person in North America to capture all 142 Pokemon Go people who are in the game, characters that are in the game. Now, Johnson started playing the game on July 6th. It took him about 2 weeks to finish. Now the Pokemon Go player says he's ready for a bigger challenge. He wants to capture all of the Pokemon in Asia, Europe, and Australia.
I'll be leaving in the next couple days and probably be gone for a week or so.
Johnson says he played the game 6 to 8 hours a day, all while holding down a 50-plus hour a week job at a tech company. He also lost 8 to 10 pounds. His advice for other Pokemon Go players is to stay safe and be aware of your surroundings. In fact, that's what I told my son this week when he headed off to Washington. Just be in the moment, be aware of your surroundings. And I think this Pokemon Go, that he solved it, it's kind of like when somebody solved the Rubik's Cube when we were kids. You know what I mean? Like,
that's true.
It just seemed impossible.
Right.
And he just put his mind to it and did it. I don't know if that's a great accomplishment in life, but.
No, but you can say it. You can now, he will be the remembered person for this particular
Nick Johnson
thing.
Yes. Not related to Dustin Johnson, who will tee off in a little while trying to defend his PGA title from last year. And all the big names are teeing off this week. And Jimmy Walker leads the PGA right now, the last major of the year, at 500.
Wow.
Stay with us. We'll be back at 5 with more news.
Donald Trump and the Republicans went first.
We're going to win. We're going to win so big.
Now it's Hillary Clinton and the Democrats' turn.
We are on the brink of a historic moment.
So what will happen next in this extraordinary election year?
We can do this.
And ABC 7 is your Suncoast connection to it all, bringing you live reports and updates all week from the Democratic National Convention. ABC 7, your Suncoast news.
Today, everyone is looking for carpeting that lasts longer. G. Freed has you covered with Karastan, With a legacy of quality and integrity, we provide you with a huge selection of Karastan carpets with exclusive lifetime limited warranties. All installed by our highly skilled, highly knowledgeable team. Come ask us why Karastan is the best and most durable. G-Fried Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.